Halt!
Maybe your small mind can understand if I speak slowly. I'm here to collect your bounty. Fine. Now get your stink away from me.
Watch your step in there, Outlander. The fighting in Ulara is faster than anything you've ever seen on the battlefields of Cyrodiil.
You'll never understand the battleground until you see the games firsthand. Get out there and participate. Of course. Now, we may have many games available. Which challenge would you like to know about?
A fire rages in your heart. That much is clear. Careful that it does not consume you. Our first Ashkhan, Nalor, favors the cautious heart. We seek silence and little else. The open path, a stiff breeze, the crunch of lava stone beneath our feet, the sighing heat of the fire river. There is no greater wealth, no greater comfort. Outsiders bring nothing but noise and sorrow. In their hearts? Yes. In their minds? No. The other Ashlanders busy themselves with prophecy and war. Eyes always on the horizon and never on their feet. But that matters little. As long as they leave us alone, we remain content.
The gift of blood and steel pleases us. More importantly, it pleases the spirit of our first Ashkhan, Shaddaa. You have the tribe's respect, for now.
The Ur-Shallaku salute you, Noir. Ashlander or no, you have proven to be wise and valorous. Our first Ashkan, Lamarck, herald of the Nereverin, treasured wisdom and valor above all else. His spirit welcomes you as a friend, as do we. We sing the truth songs, the truth of the three blasphemers, and the Daedra, and the Nereverin. The houses hate us most of all. Because we do not forget the truth of Nerevar, we know that the Tribunal will pass like wood smoke, driven away by the raging winds of the Incarnate. Vec, Sothasil, and the Madwife know this as well. They seek to silence us, but they always fail.
Those who labor long prosper. Those who hunt long starve. These are the words of our first Ashkan, Akami. You honor him.
I saw Olmilexia herself. I am forever blessed by the Healing Mother.
You surprise me, outsider. All here assembled say you are both brave and courteous. A hero worthy of praise. Yet, I still sense a hidden motive. You showed us respect, so I will do the same by asking you directly. What really brings you to Aldrin? I do not know this name, Hleron, but there is an ancestral tomb nearby. It hides among the rocks to the west, beyond the fire river we call Drura. I would not go there, outsider. Tombs are like guars. Left untended, they grow wild and feral. No, but I have heard their cries. The spirits that dwell there sound anguished. They have a story to tell, I think. They long to be remembered. I'm sorry, but I have no ear for their tales. My basket is already full of the Ashlander's troubles.
Some first-rate diplomacy. You're practically a clan friend already. I saw you speaking to the wise woman. What did she say? No surprise there. Without communion, our ancestors grow agitated. We Dark Elves tend to be prickly in life. We're doubly so in death. I have to know if the tomb belongs to my family, but I'm in no great hurry to cut down the spirits of my ancestors. Would you? What a relief. Take this sash. It bears the Hleron family crest. If the spirits lurking in the tomb are of Hleron blood, they'll recognize it. It might not keep them from attacking, but it should convince them that your motives are pure. Anything that could prove it's my family's tomb, seals, engravings, anything. You could also try talking to the spirits. The tablet I found referred to someone named Dranarth, a family patriarch. Perhaps you'll find him inside. Three protect you.